Their destination is a street that divides two famous boroughs, Islington and Camden. One a trendy shopping district whose back streets are lined with antique shops. The other a hotspot of canalside bars. For 13 years, Paul Borman has run the Emporium and has collected bric-a-brac since he was a child.
My grandfather was in charge of the tip. He'd bring the odd interesting thing home, like a three-legged tortoise or a piano. We used to chop pianos up and put them on the fire. It is such a mixed area here. You've got people with, you know, really quite expensive lifestyles down to people with really, really very inexpensive lifestyles. And that's what I love about being here, really, is it really is very different.
Excellent. Oh, yes. This is my favourite type of shop. I love shops like this. I really do.
Thank you.
We are going to be here some time, I'm afraid, T.
OK.
These shops are getting thin on the ground. There used to be two or three in every town, and now, you know, you'll barely find one. I don't know, it's just magic for me. I love them.
How long have you been here?
About 8 o'clock.
13 years.
You're always looking for that little gem, that thing that has not been spotted yet.
I like that. No price on that? Hang on.
99. 70. 50? 60.
65.
OK. Deal.
Excellent.
Thank you. There you go. I'll just buy small things.
Lovely.
I promise.
Lots of small.
Loving that.
No, don't do that.
Dating from the 1940s, this lens light hawk lamp was made by the lighting company EDL. Founded in the 1920s, they're still in the industrial lighting business today. Once the steel base and Bakelite lamp head are cleaned up, this could be worth around £200.
All it needs is rewiring, and there's a piece of glass that's missing from underneath the light. So we'll get it back, rewire it, cost about £65 to put it all right, get a piece of glass done, give it a colour polish and sell it straight away. No price on that one, fella.
Sold, mate.
Sold?
Yeah, okay. Sorry.
Like that. Likes his lights, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what got you into the business then?
My father used to go out and buy big loads of stuff, and I think I always kind of liked that. Like, he'd buy a van full of corned beef or a house full of wood. And it's my ambition to have owned everything in the world at least once.
You're on your way.
Yeah, you're doing quite well in here.
I always ask every dealer, anywhere I go, where's the good stuff? What have you got tucked away? Anything really tasty come in?
Oil lamp base.
Oh. Have you had one of these before?
No.
Interesting.
Making a nice lamp.
Yeah.
Someone with the time and the inclination.
Yeah.
This lamp base has no maker's mark, but elephants have inspired artists for thousands of years. Europeans find them exotic, while they're revered in Asia and Africa. This lamp could be of European origin from the early 19th century. With a cast iron base supporting a copper patinated pot, it could be worth around £500 after restoration.
We found this fantastic oil lamp base. It's going to make a beautiful table lamp. It really is something really special. I've not seen one before. What sort of money is that? It's a bit of a project, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bit of a project. A trade on that 90. Excellent.
But no, I'm just thinking, just needs a bulb there with a nice low shade.
Yeah.
That's all it needs, really.
People love an elephant.
Mm. Worth coming for that one thing. If I'd just bought one thing today, that elephant lamp would have made it, for sure. God, that's unusual. Tell me about that. What's that made out of?
It's like a sort of resin, but it's just sort of, it's a great look.
Yeah, can I have a closer look at it?
It's an adult coming through, Drew.
Lift me up, too.
Nice, that.
Yeah.
A strange thing. It's been added to the base later.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, it's a trophy base or something.
It's plaster, cement and stuff. It's like a brutalist sort of look, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
The Brutalist movement flourished in the 1960s and 70s in architecture and various art forms. The term comes from a French phrase, béton brut, or raw concrete, the favoured building material of Brutalist architects. This intriguing sculpture is in excellent condition and could be worth around £200.
It was a type of art form that was very much in your face, and it was, you either love it or hate it.
What do you think? Sort of life-size as well, isn't it?
Not sure about that.
It does look enough like bronze, though. It's really well done.
Yeah.
What's the best on it?
What's it got on the ticket?
£85.
Very best, 70.
Yeah.
Good. Shall I put it with your pile?
Yeah, it's signed.
Oh, now it's signed.
Yeah. Having a signature on anything tends to help it along. But a lot of fakes and junk had signature on them as well. That's not a fake of anything, and it's not junk, so the signature could be of more importance. Is there anywhere else we can have a look around?
Yeah, there's a basement.
Can I have a look there now? Where's that?
Yeah, come.
This way.
Downstairs, funny enough.
Underneath.
It's a bit tight down here, so I think I'm going to leave you to it. If you need anything, just give me a shout.
All right.
Okay.
There are three rooms downstairs, chock-a-block with potential salvage.
Oh, look. Oh, gone.
That's a shame.
Little Moroccan side table, they sell really well. Need to see that in the light. T?
Yeah?
Can I hand you something, mate? I think it's too rotten, but we'll see. Too much work. 19th century, not 18th. Nice, though.
Not dear.
Nah, it's just the work. It's not that. It's not the price. And I know the price would be right, but nah. There was one sabre-legged, rattan-seated dining chair, ebonized with brass detail. It could be an 18th century one. Bring it up here. It's 19th century. It's had 5 repairs that I can see to the frame. It's woodward and rotten, and the seat is ripped as well, so total no-no.
With 3 great finds under his belt, Drew takes one last look around the Emporium to make sure there's nothing he's missed.
That's an odd one, isn't it?
Yeah.
How strange. Look at that. What's all that about?
Clipped onto something.
A strange little thing.
This mid-20th century lamp boasts an aluminium shade supported on a ball and socket joint. It would work just as well as an upright table lamp, or upside down, supported on the clip mechanism hidden inside the rubberized base. The lamp could be worth around £120 after restoration.
Straightforward clean, rewire, not over-polish, put an inline switch on it as well, maybe change the bulb holder over. It'll sell as a little side light of somebody's house. 35 on it, what can you do?
£30.
Really?
Really.
Not £25.
Good one, then.
Thank you. Paul is the sort of person I do really enjoy buying off, because they love the job. And when he just likes buying and selling stuff, it's an addiction. And coming to shops like this and dealing with proper dealers, it's just great fun. It's like a day out. We can turn a profit on all of that. We can add value to every single piece. But all in all, a really good little trade stop, that, actually. Very pleased. But then there's two things. There's the elephant lamp, just really interesting, different, fresh to the market, exactly what we need to do all of the time. And we might get very, very lucky with the bust. Trip here worthwhile? Yes. We'll always buy, we'll always sell, we'll meet new contacts. This is definitely now another trade call for me. If I'm passing, I'll always stop.
I'm not surprised by anything Drew bought, because I've been doing this too long to be surprised by anything that anybody ever bought. I hope Drew's happy with what he's got. He's got a bit of stock and I've got rid of a bit of stock, so the world goes round.
Done.
Yeah, sorry.
Benito.
Yeah. Well done.
Marvellous.
All right. Well, thank you very much
pleasure.
For coming. It's been a pleasure. Cheers, enjoy.
Thank you.
Cheers.
See you later.
Bye.